Why are plants green, or why are plants mostly green? Now, except for when the leaves change color and so they become reddish or violetish. For most part, leaves and grasses and trees and plants, they are green. But why are they green? Before I answer this question, let me ask you this. Have you ever seen a rainbow? You must have observed that a rainbow is composed of 7 colors: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. Green comes in the middle. So that's fact number one. Now let's talk about nature. Nature always favors effectiveness and not efficiency. What do I mean by this? So we think that nature is very efficient. There's no waste in nature, but nature is not efficient. Nature is very effective. For example, why do most terrestrial animals have legs? Why do we not have spherical or circular legs? Because if you think about it, a circular shape leg would be very efficient, isn't it? That's why buses and cars and trains have wheels. Why the nature doesn't fit us with wheelie legs or wheelie things to go around is because, of course, it is efficient, but it's not very effective because the terrain, natural terrain, is very variable. So legs are best suited to go on any terrain, not only on plain, but also if you have to go through a shallow river, or you have to go up a mountain, or you have to go down a valley. Nature favors effective structures such as feet and legs and not efficient structures such as wheels. You should be able to face most number of problem cases around you, and that's effectiveness. What's the link between this nature favors effectiveness and not efficiency with the color of plants being green? A plant needs sunlight so that it can make food via the process of photosynthesis. If nature were efficient, the plant or the leaf would try to capture as much sunlight as possible so that it can make as much food as possible. And what color consumes the most light? It's black. Black does not reflect any light at all. If nature were efficiency seeking, then all our plants would be black in color. Luckily, that's not the case. Nature seeks effectiveness.
So let's see how nature manages the green part of sunlight. Actually, the green part of the sunlight has the most energy, but plant goes for actually absorbing only 90% of the green light. And the reason plants do so is because for the plant, the energy that it gets from sunlight is not as important as making sure the intensity of the energy that it gets from the sunlight doesn't fluctuate too much. If the intensity fluctuates too much through the day, it's very dangerous for the plant. Too less intensity, the plant does not have enough energy to carry out photosynthesis. And too much intensity will kill the plant. So the plant doesn't want to absorb as much energy as it could. Instead, the plant prefers to reflect back 10% of the green light so that the total intensity of energy that it gets from a fluctuating sun, for example, the sun sends very low intensity light in the morning and in the evening, and very high intensity light in the afternoon, the plant doesn't want to fluctuate its total intensity of the energy that it gets from the sunlight. And that's why it reflects 10% of the green light. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.